I'm Joshua Bardwell, and this weekend I will be presenting a PID tuning masterclass at the New York City Drone Film Festival, March 2017, since things live forever on the internet. Many of you won't be able to make that, and that's okay, because it will eventually get posted online. I've made sure that I have permission to post it to my channel, so you will get to see that presentation. It'll be more of the same PID tuning goodness that you're used to seeing from me. In the lead up to that, though, I have some video that I shot, and I shot the video to use in the PID tuning masterclass, but of course I shot lots of video talking about PIDs and so forth, so I'm going to be rolling out that video over the course of this week, and some other good stuff too, not just that, since I know not everybody's into the PIDs. And then leading up to that, when I'll give the final presentation on, I think it's Saturday afternoon. I should really check on when it is. I'll give the final presentation at the film festival. Okay, so here is the beginning of that. Thanks for watching. Enjoy. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to turn my P gains way down, and let's get a look at what that looks like. That's pretty good, I think. And then also, let's turn the D gains all the way down to zero, so that we can, when we raise the P gains later, we'll see the effect of not having D, and then we'll see the effect of adding D in. Okay, now we're gonna fly like this. And it's gonna be hard to fly like this, but I think I can do it. But the copter is gonna be really sloppy and require a lot of stick input to get it to do what it needs to do. It's gonna feel really sloppy and imprecise. See that wobble there? If I try and do some precise flying like this, I'm gonna find it hard to do. It's actually not as I would expect with the P's this low. You can see there the prop wash handling is really poor. And that's the lack of D, I think, more than anything. There, see that? See that soft oscillation there? Right there, the sort of lower frequency, soft oscillation. That's low P gain. It's having a lot of trouble here. It's still pretty flyable. I'm really amazed at how flyable it is with the P gains this low. But you can see that we're getting those prop wash oscillations on sharper turns. If we do some flips and rolls, let's see what we get. Big bounce there at the end of a roll. Let's look at a flip. Big oscillation, multiple oscillations there. There again, soft oscillations there. You see the multiple oscillations at the end of the flip, not just one rebound, but that was more like one rebound. But we also saw multiple oscillations there, and that's usually indicative of high P gain, but because those oscillations were so soft, and we know this is low P gain, those soft oscillations are indicative of low P gain. What I want to do now is I want to start raising those P gains up, and I'm not going to change the D gains at all. Let's just take them to 3, and you're going to see. And I'm going to leave yaw alone for now. I don't think yaw is going to be as visible, so we'll leave that alone. Now I'm going to do the same sort of maneuvers, and let's look at the difference. Here's some prop wash. The prop wash handling is already better. Still a really big bounce there at the end of the roll. The bounce at the end of the flip wasn't as big. No, much better for the flip. Let's look at another roll. Ooh, real problem with prop wash there. The roll is getting a much sharper stop, but we're still definitely seeing some prop wash oscillation though. Let's go ahead and raise this up again. Now we'll put them at 40. We're gonna leave yaw alone. I don't think yaw is gonna have as visible effect on the handling. Mostly I think I tune yaw by feel, and I just don't think it's gonna be super visible. So I'm gonna leave that alone. Let's look at the prop wash handling first. Doing these. It's getting better. You can see that it's getting better. Let's look at a flip or a roll. Big bounce there, and I got a battery critical warning. Battery's just getting lower. That flip was not too bad. We seem to be doing better with flips than with rolls. It may have to do with the fact that this is a stretched X copter. Yeah, big. Do you see how the rebound, the oscillation after the rolls, is getting, I would say it's getting sharper versus softer. It's getting higher frequency. As you raise the P gains, you'll start to get those sharp oscillations coming out. Let's keep raising them. Okay, so now we're at 50. I don't think we flew this one, so we'll go ahead and fly it. Let's look at the prop wash first. The prop wash handling is continuing to improve. The prop wash oscillation is getting higher frequency and smaller magnitude. So instead of big, soft oscillations, let's do a drop. Big, soft oscillations. That was pretty good. No oscillation there on a drop and raise the throttle. Let's look at a flip and a roll. Big bounce there still. I don't think that's going to get fixed until we add some D gain. Big bounce there as well. Yeah. Those are getting sharper. Smaller magnitude and higher frequency. And as we continue to raise P, that's going to continue to happen. And we're going to see why we need D gain. Why P alone cannot fix it. Let's continue to raise the P gains. Now we're at 60. Now, do you see how that oscillation didn't die out as fast, but kind of cascaded on itself? See how it keeps going until I drop the throttle? That means our P gains are getting too high. It's gonna get more and more unsettled. See, it's just continuing to do it. It's not settling itself, but it's feeding back into itself, and it can't control it. It can't let the oscillation die out on its own. Pretty good there on the drop, but in the prop wash scenario, it's really having trouble. Let's look at a flip and a roll. Yeah, do you see that? That's high P gain right there. The P gain is too high. And you see, it's just all the time. Not so much on flip, though. Flips have been better than rolls, generally. Oh, yeah. So it's starting to get not as controllable, isn't it? These oscillations are sort of happening all the time. The copter's getting harder and harder to control. I'm having to really manage the throttle. I'm having to back off on the throttle. in order to keep the oscillations from cascading out of control. Let's raise it a little more just so we see what happens as we get too much. If I raise the throttle in a straight line, I don't get any oscillation. But anytime I do sharp turns, the oscillations start to come out. Flips and rolls. Oh, there was an oscillation there. Just raising the throttle gave me an oscillation. See, that's excess P gain. That's what it looks like. Oh yeah, oh yeah. I'm constantly having to back off the throttle to let those oscillations subside. They're not subsiding on their own, are they? If we look at a flip, how are we doing on a flip? Oh, see, I can't even punch out for a flip now because these oscillations are just too much. And if we just look at a little blip. You can hear the oscillations there. Yeah, this is excess P gain right here. This is it. So let's land now. This is only going to get worse, so I'm not going to keep going. Now, what I could do is back the P gain off, but I'm not going to do that because what I can do instead is add D gain. We've got zero D gain, and D gain will have the effect of, you think of D gain as damping, but it's not really just damping. Let me fly this one back in because we're at 15 volts. You think of D gain as having the effect of damping the P gain. People think D equals damping. D gain doesn't just damp the P gain, but it does have the effect of sort of taming the P term oscillations. It also has an accelerating effect. What D gain actually does is it accelerates both directions. It accelerates when the PID sum is growing, it makes it grow faster, but when it's decreasing, it makes it decrease faster. And the decrease faster is the one that's sort of most noticeable. So let's go ahead and save this. And we will now start adding some D-term.